Hello. Buenas tardes. Welcome to the recital of Love and Loss. I'm Eric X. Eric Salinas, as most of you know me, and I'm very excited to be performing all of these pieces for you today. Putting this whole recital together has been a combination of all of my work for the past 3 years, and it is so rewarding to be able to do it my way completely, down to the stage, the makeup, the outfit, the choir. It's such an honor, and I'm so excited to bring all of these beautiful, diverse pieces to you today. The pieces are something that I am very proud of. The program is very diverse. It has a lot of different people from different backgrounds, different identities, different times, which we don't usually see a lot of. And I'm so happy to bring that to you today because I believe that that difference, that diversity is what draws us all together, because we can all have something that speaks to us, something important, something that we can just hear and we know that's talking to me. That is what this first song was to me in high school. I know this is the love section and that didn't exactly sound like it, but it is my idea of love, my interpretation, because I read the words one time in high school and I just started weeping, and I knew this is what music is. This is what it's supposed to be. It's supposed to bring people to this climax of emotions and just hold you there. So I'm excited to bring all of these pieces to you today, and hopefully they'll do that for you. Next up will be The Stars by Samuel Coleridge Taylor, a very beautiful piece from the Five Fairy Ballads, and then the rest of the program will go uninterrupted until our choir. So thank you very much for being here.
Onward, weary pilgrims, passaste a mi lado con gran indiferencia. Tus ojos ni siquiera voltearon hacia mí. Te vi sin que me oyeras, te hablé sin que me oyeras, y todo mi amargura se ahogó dentro de mí. Bring you.
I hope y'all enjoyed the first part of the Love and Loss Recital, Love. Yeah, okay. Yeah. These songs all have a very special place in my heart, especially Songs to the Dark Virgin that I just performed. It's very beautiful. It was written by Florence Price, who is an African-American woman composer back from the earlier 1900s. And she composed incredible music. And unfortunately, it wasn't as documented as it should have been back in the day. But now we have Dr. Cooper to bring it to life. And we're also thankful for that. And I'm so thankful to be able to perform it here today. And so next, we are going to be having a choir piece. This is my first ever ensemble that I've conducted. So I'm very thankful for them for being so patient to me. But it's been such an amazing experience with them. Getting to teach such beautiful music is so rewarding, and it just fills me with so much joy that I didn't know was going to be there. So I'm very thankful for that. And I'm very thankful for everybody in the choir. Y'all can see on y'all's programs the list of names. They have been so dedicated towards making this program so incredible for me, and I'm so thankful for that, and I'm so incredibly excited for you to be able to meet them all. Are y'all ready?
Yes!
So, without further ado, here is O Love, performed by the Choir of Ecstasy.
Thank you.
And that has been the love section. So now go forward into intermission, words, and we'll take about a 10-minute break, and then we can come back and we'll get into loss. All right.
Thank you. Welcome back.
So I hope y'all enjoyed Love. So now we're going to get into some more serious topics. We're going to get into loss. So loss is a very powerful emotion, and I truly believe that love and loss do go hand in hand. New love makes room for new loss, and new loss makes room for new love. And yin-yang type of situation, they go hand in hand. And so I truly believe that this was the perfect way to put them together. I would draw y'all in with the love and then trap y'all with the loss. Common theme. Anyways, yes, so this first piece is called AIDS Anxiety. It's from the AIDS Quilt Songbook. And the AIDS Quilt Songbook was a very important songbook that was commissioned by William Parker, who's a very famous baritone. And he put together, he got all of these different composers of the 90s, the 80s and 90s, he got them together to make different pieces about the AIDS crisis, whether it was about the experience of having it, the experience of, you know, losing someone to it. They all put their own interpretation on it. And it was a collection of, I think, about 12 songs. And I found it in my first year here in the library, and I gravitated towards it because I've always been such a queer historian. And I fell in love with all the songs, and I'm so happy to be presenting four of them here today. AIDS Anxiety, I Never Knew, Walt Whitman in 1989, and Better Nail. Each of them very different, very beautiful, and very telling of the times. So that will be the main part of this section of the recital. AIDS Anxiety is very important to me. It's very theatrical, it's very funny, but it's also very serious. It talks about the anxiety surrounding AIDS back when it barely even had a name. Back when it didn't really have, you know, nobody knew how it was spread and all that, it was so new. And hundreds of thousands of people died because of the lack of response from the government, and many people ended up speaking out about it. And in the fine arts world, it was artists, it was, you know, symphonies, orchestras, everybody but the vocalist had spoken out. And William Parker decided this is how we are going to do it. And it was done so beautifully. And AIDS Anxiety is a trio piece originally for three baritones. And I was going to do it that way. But as I researched it more, I found that the composer arranged it for solo piece, as a solo piece for William Parker to perform when they went and toured with it. But sadly, before it could be performed, he died of AIDS. And so tonight I will be performing it as a solo piece in memoriam to him. So please enjoy AIDS Anxiety.
Second thought to a pimple ward.
Connotation now, but he's a lawyer, so I'm not sure I should trust him. Well, I finally came in and met him for dinner. I was too nervous to eat or talk much, but still he invited me home with a proverbial drink and whatever. By now I was feeling great.
I hope to fall.
Walt Whitman has come down today to the hospital room. He rocks back and forth in the crisis. He says it's good we haven't lost our closeness, and cries as each one is taken. He has written many lines about these years, the disfigurement of young men and the wars of hearts on body in pain will bear such nobility, but words at the edge of poison, when spoken bitterly, now he takes a dying man in his arms and tells him how deep takes the old man and his friends this evening. It is the river of dusk and lamentation. Oh. I relax the tissue underneath.
y las abejas pican los labios abiertos de la espuma.
And that has been the solo section of this recital, everybody. Stay seated because we still have one more choral piece. But yeah, that was Betanail. That was by Libby Larson from the AIDS Quilt Songbook. It is a beautiful piece about insanity because whenever you would get AIDS, sometimes people would take a, they would call it a mocktail, or yeah, a cocktail of different pills to try and help. And a lot of the times people would go crazy. And that insanity right there is the embodiment of that. And it is done so well. And I just love to go absolutely batshit crazy when I perform it. It's beautiful. So now we have Prince of Peace. Prince of Peace is the fourth movement out of Margaret Bond's Credo. It is the centerpiece. And it is all about activism. It is all about a call to action. It is so incredibly powerful. And I knew that I had to do it in the wake of, you know, everything that's going on in Palestine. I don't think it's right. And we are here today to sing against that because all art is protest and up here. This is art, this is queer art, this is musical art, and you are experiencing it all and you're supporting it. And that is truly incredible. And I am so thankful for y'all to be here to see all of this. I have asked my choir to create a page to go inside of their binder that will represent their own Prince of Peace, somebody that speaks to them, somebody that is meaningful towards them, a activist, a movement, something. And they all did an amazing job with it. I also asked them to dress very, very nicely today, very out of the box. And so we want to appreciate that. So I will have every section come up here and promote their movement and promote their outfit. And I will show y'all mine first. Let me go get it. My activist is Sylvia Rivera. She is a Latina trans woman that was very influential towards trans rights in the 80s and 90s. She was not remembered fondly, and she was not remembered well by people because she spoke out, and she did it so fiercely that a lot of people thought, this doesn't belong here. And a lot of people thought, trans women do not belong in the gay rights movement. It was queer rights, and it was trans women and drag queen and the street people that fought for these rights, and they still did not get the recognition they deserved. And I think Sylvia deserves so much and to be remembered. And that is what we're here to tonight, to remember and to uplift voices that are not always uplifted. And so without further ado, I introduce the tenors of the Choir of Ecstasy. Now we have the sopranos. Now we have the altos. And lastly, the basses. They're they will all have their binders out in the lobby afterwards. After this, there will be a refreshments, and you can ask them all about it and look closer if you wish. But yeah, enjoy Prince of Peace by Margaret Bonds.
Thank you.
This has been the Love and Loss Recital by Eric X. Thank you all, and go forward in peace and love.